This LOS is describe the International Accounting Standards Board's conceptual framework, including the objective and qualitative characteristics of financial statements, required reporting elements, and constraints and assumptions in preparing financial statements. Okay, this is the longest set of slides for one LOS. And so I'm just starting with a quick study tip again. This reading is a perfect example of CFA Level 1 exam being an English test, subject in this case accounting. In many review sessions, most candidates realize that this reading, and in particular this LOS, is one where they need to go back and memorize many lists using mnemonics. There's lots of memorization in this reading. There's some keywords, principles, assumptions, characteristics, qualities, factors, etc. And it all sounds pretty good when you start to look at the practice questions. Everything sounds so similar, yet you have to be very precise in your understanding and precise in the exact words that they're using with regards to these accounting concepts. The International Financial Reporting Standards Framework. Based on International Accounting Standard, general requirements for financial statements, fundamental principles include 1. Fair presentation, 2. Going concern, 3. Accrual basis, 4. Consistency, and 5. Materiality. So again, you can see I've put into bold here fundamental principles, and there's 5 principles. You have to know those 5 principles and have them memorized as such. So an example of a practice question. Under IFRS, which of the following is most likely one of the fundamental principles underlying the preparation of financial statements? A. Reliability, B. Consistency, or C. Understandability. The correct answer is B. Based on International Accounting Standard IAS general requirements for financial statements, fundamental principles include fair presentation, going concern, accrual basis, consistency, and materiality. So I have the 5 listed there, and I put bold in green consistency. You can see this is a perfect example. As I said, reliability and understandability sound pretty good, but the list of the 5 principles is very exact, and you have to know that consistency is the correct fundamental principle. Reliability and understandability were both wrong. Okay, now we're going to look at the International Financial Reporting Standards Framework. So we start here in the center with the objective, and the objective is to provide financial information useful in making decisions about providing resources to the entity. And then as we move out, we hit the qualitative characteristics, and you can see I've got them listed here. There's a list of 6: relevance, faithful representation, comparability, verifiability, timeliness, and understandability. So those are 6 qualitative characteristics, and as you can see, I've just made a little bit of a mnemonic there, RFCVTU. You're going to have to come up with some way to memorize these 6 qualitative characteristics. As we move out from there, you can see that we have constraints on financial reports, which is a cost benefit and a timeliness. There's timeliness in the practice question, which we'll see a little bit later. Then as we move out, we have the reporting elements of financial statements. We've seen this in a previous LOS, so this one should be easy. The elements of financial statements are assets, liabilities, equity, assets equals liabilities plus equity, and then from the income statement, income and expenses. Not net income. Net income is a product of revenue minus expenses. Okay, so just be careful with the wording there as well. And then finally, we come down to some underlying assumptions in financial statements. One is the accrual basis, and 2 is the going concern, okay? So again, there's a lot of questions that can be related to this framework. 6 qualitative characteristics, the constraints on financial reports, the reporting elements should be fairly easy, the underlying assumptions, and so therefore, as I said, you have to make some lists, 6 qualitative, 4 elements, 2 assumptions. And you need to be careful because there's some following practice questions that will show you that there's more to memorize beyond this framework. There's, for example, there's 5 factors that contribute to reliability. The International Financial Reporting Standards Framework. Objective of financial reports. The objective of financial reports is the provision of financial information that is useful to current and potential providers of resources in making decisions. All other aspects of the framework flow from that central objective. Qualitative characteristics of financial reports. Flowing from the central objective of providing information that is useful to providers of resources, the conceptual framework in 2010 elaborates on what constitutes usefulness. It identifies two fundamental qualitative characteristics that make financial information useful: relevance and faithful representation. Relevance: information is relevant if it would potentially affect or make a difference in users' decisions. And two, faithful representation: information that faithfully represents an economic phenomenon that it purports to represent is ideally complete, neutral, and free from any error. Relevance and faithful representation are the fundamental, most critical characteristics of useful financial information. In addition to these two fundamental characteristics, the conceptual framework identifies four other characteristics that enhance the usefulness of relevant and faithfully represented financial information. These enhancing qualitative characteristics are comparability, verifiability, timeliness, and understandability. Comparability. Comparability allows users to identify and understand similarities and differences of items. Information presented in a consistent manner over time and across entities enables users to make comparisons more easily than information with variations in how similar economic phenomena are represented. Verifiability. Verifiability means that different knowledgeable and independent observers would agree that the information presented faithfully represents the economic phenomena it purports to represent. Timeliness. Timely information is available to decision makers prior to making their decision. Understandability. Clear and concise presentation of information enhances understandability. The conceptual framework specifies that information is prepared for and should be understandable by users who have a reasonable knowledge of business and economic activities and who are willing to study the information with diligence. Constraints on financial reports. A pervasive constraint on useful financial reporting is the cost of providing and using this information. Optimally, benefits derived from information should exceed the cost of providing and using it. So the constraints is basically a cost-benefit situation. The elements of financial statements. Three elements of financial statements are directly related to the measurement of financial position: assets, liabilities, and equity. Recall, assets equals liabilities plus equity. Assets minus liabilities equals equity. Assets. This is important with regards to these specific definitions. Assets are resources controlled by the enterprise as a result of past events and from which future economic benefits are expected to flow to the enterprise. So I put that in bold. It's very important. Assets are what a company owns, inventory and equipment, for example. Liabilities. Liabilities are present obligations of an enterprise arising from past events, the settlement of which is expected to result in an outflow of resources embodying economic benefits. Liabilities are what a company owes, for example, bank borrowings. And finally, equity for public companies, known as shareholders' equity or stockholders' equity, is assets less liabilities. Equity is the residual interest in the assets after subtracting the liabilities. Continuing now with the elements of the financial statements. The elements of financial statements directly related to the measurement of performance, profit, and related measures are income and expenses. Income: increases in economic benefits in the form of inflows or enhancements of assets or decreases of liabilities that result in an increase in equity, other than increases resulting from contributions by owners. Income includes both revenues and gains. Revenues represent income from the ordinary activities of the enterprise, for example, the sale of products. Gains may result from ordinary activities or other activities, the sale of surplus equipment. Expenses. Expenses are decreases in economic benefits in the form of outflows or depletion of assets or increases in liabilities that result in decreases in equity, other than decreases because of distributions to owners such as dividends. Expenses include losses, as well as those items normally thought of as expenses, such as the cost of goods sold or wages. Underlying assumptions in financial statements. Two important assumptions underline financial statements: accrual accounting and going concern. These assumptions determine how financial statement elements are recognized and measured. The use of accrual accounting assumes that financial statements should reflect transactions in the period when they actually occur, not necessarily when cash movements occur. Going concern refers to the assumption that the company will continue in business for the foreseeable future. Recognition of financial statement elements. Recognition means that an item is included in the balance sheet or income statement. Recognition occurs if the item meets the definition of an element and satisfies the criteria for recognition. A financial statement element, assets, liabilities, equity, income, and expenses, should be recognized in the financial statements if, one, it is probable that any future economic benefit associated with the item will flow to or from the enterprise, and two, the item has a cost or value that can be measured with reliability. Measurement of financial statement elements. Historical cost. Historical cost is simply the amount of cash or cash equivalents paid to purchase an asset, including any costs of acquisition and or preparation. If the asset was not bought for cash, historical cost is the fair value of whatever was given in order to buy the asset. When referring to liabilities, the historical cost basis of measurement means the amount of proceeds received in exchange for the obligation. Amortized cost. Historical cost adjusted for amortization, depreciation, or depletion and/or impairment. Current cost. In reference to assets, current cost is the amount of cash or cash equivalents that would have to be paid to buy the same or an equivalent asset today. In reference to liabilities, the current cost basis of measurement means the undiscounted amount of cash or cash equivalents that would be required to settle the obligation today. Carrying on with the measurement of financial statement elements, realizable settlement value. In reference to assets, realizable value is the amount of cash or cash equivalents that could currently be obtained by selling the asset in an orderly disposal. For liabilities, the equivalent to realizable value is called settlement value. Present value. For assets, present value is the present discounted value of the future net cash inflows that the asset is expected to generate in the normal course of business. For liabilities, present value is the present discounted value of the future net cash outflows that are expected to be required to settle the liabilities in the normal course of business. Fair value. Fair value is a measure of value mentioned but not specifically defined in the conceptual framework. Fair value is the amount at which an asset could be exchanged or a liability settled between knowledgeable, willing parties in an arm's length transaction. This may involve either market measures or present value measures, depending on the availability of information. The International Financial Reporting Standards Framework. The IFRS framework identifies five factors that contribute to reliability. 1. Faithful representation. 2. Substance over form. 3. Neutrality. 4. Prudence. And 5. Completeness. Investors require timeliness, transparency, comparability, and consistency in financial reporting. Investors have a preference for decision relevance over reliability. A comprehensive business reporting model, financial reporting for investors. There's three characteristics of an effective financial reporting framework. One is transparency, two is comprehensiveness, and three is consistency. So again, this is another slide where some memorization slides need to be made. So you've got the IFRS framework here. Again, as I'd mentioned before, the five factors that contribute to reliability needs to be memorized. And it all sounds pretty good compared to the qualitative factors, etc. Okay? And then further on that, we've got the three characteristics of an effective financial reporting framework: transparency, comprehensiveness, consistency. A lot of these words sound very similar. They all sound pretty good. So when you start to look at the practice questions, you have to be very exact with your language and very precise with your lists. So I like to put in a practice question just to emphasize that point on the precision and the memorization level that's needed to really tackle this. Neutrality of information in financial statements most closely contributes to what qualitative characteristic? A, relevance, B, understandability, or C, faithful representation? Neutrality of information in the financial statements most closely contributes to C, faithful representation. The fundamental qualitative characteristic of faithful representation is contributed to by completeness, neutrality, and freedom for error. And that was in the previous slide, you'll recall. Faithful representation, information that faithfully represents an economic phenomenon that it purports to represent, is ideally complete, neutral, which I put in bold green, and free from error. So the correct answer was C. And I think you can see from this type of question that the need to be very precise with your memorization, as I've said now a couple of times. Another practice problem. Under the IASB conceptual framework, one of the qualitative characteristics of useful financial information is that different knowledgeable users would agree that the information is a faithful representation of the economic events that is intended to represent. This characteristic is best described as A, verifiability, B, comparability, or C, understandability. A is correct. Under the International Accounting Standards Board's conceptual framework, verifiability is the qualitative characteristic that means the different knowledgeable and independent users would agree that the information presented faithfully represents the economic events that it is intended to represent. Another quick practice question. According to the IFRS framework, which of the following is the least likely qualitative characteristic that makes financial information useful? A, materiality, B, comparability, or C, understandability? Okay, the correct answer is A, because it was looking for the least likely. The six principal qualitative characteristics that make financial information useful are 1, relevance, 2, faithful representation, 3, comparability, which I put in bold and green, that was the correct one, 4, verifiability, 5, timeliness, and finally 6, understandability. So you can see comparability and understandability are both there. They're most likely to be qualitative characteristics. The least likely one was materiality. Materiality relates to the level of detail of information needed to achieve relevance, whether the omission or misstatement of the information would impact the decision maker's decision. Under IFRS, which of the following statement elements most accurately represents inflows of economic resources to a company? A, assets, B, equity, or C, revenues? So another good question to help us with our memorization. C is correct. Again, the financial statement elements under IFRS are assets, liabilities, owner's equity, revenues, and expenses. Revenues are the inflows of economic resources. Assets are economic resources, but they're not inflows. Another practice question. To be recognized as a financial statement element under IFRS framework for the preparation and presentation of financial statements, an element most appropriately needs to A, have a cost or value that can be measured with reliability, B, normally be carried at historical cost, current cost, or fair market value, or C, provide certainty that any future economic benefit associated with the item will flow to or from the enterprise. The correct answer is A. For recognition in the financial statements, an element must have a cost or value that can be measured with reliability. Certainty is not a requirement for economic benefits associated with an item to flow to or from the enterprise. All that is required is that it is probable that they will. Another quick practice question to test your memorization. According to the IFRS framework, which of the following qualities of financial information is least likely to improve its reliability? A, neutrality, B, consistency, or C, substance over form? The correct answer is B, because we're looking for the least likely. We're looking for the one that is incorrect. The IFRS framework identifies five factors that contribute to reliability: faithful representation, substance over form, neutrality, prudence, and completeness. You can see that consistency is not one of them. So again, this was a list that you had to memorize, the five factors that contribute to reliability, an example of a type of question where two are right, one was wrong, and you had to identify the incorrect one. This could easily be a type of question where they give you three choices, one is right and two are wrong. And again, a lot of the wording sounds so correct and similar, you've got to be very precise with your memorization and your lists. And one last quick practice problem to finish this LOS. Which of the following is a constraint as defined in the IFRS framework for the preparation and presentation of financial statements? A, neutrality, B, timeliness, or C, going concern? Okay, the correct answer is B. Timeliness is a constraint in the IFRS framework. Neutrality is a factor that contributes to reliability, and going concern is an assumption of the framework. So that's the last slide for this LOS. We did a lot of practice questions, but I just want to remind candidates studying for the CFA Level 1, financial reporting is 20% of the exam, which is 48 questions. There's 24 in the morning, there's 24 in the afternoon, and yet most of the questions in accounting don't involve any calculations. There's a lot of questions such as we've done with regards to this LOS, where it's an English language test, subject accounting, so you just have to put the work into making your list, doing your memorization, and you'll be fine. On that note, that's the last slide for this LOS. Thank you.